proofs of remaining properties of homomorphism. Let phi, first these are the properties. Let phi from G to G cap be a homomorphism and A belongs to G. Then phi of E is equals to E cap. Nothing but the identity element is mapping with identity only. Next, second one, phi of A to the power of N is equals to phi of A whole to the power of N for all N belongs to Z plus, and phi of A inverse is equals to phi of A whole inverse. What's the third one? Modulus of A is a finite, then modulus of phi of A divides modulus of A. Fourth one, ker pi is a subgroup of capital G. Fifth one, the homomorphic image phi of G is a subgroup of G cap. So, third one, if modulus of A is a finite, then modulus of phi of A divides modulus of A. Here, modulus of A is finite means order of A. By the definition of order of an element, modulus of A is equals to N, implies A to the power of N is equals to E. From property 2, what is the property 2? Phi of A to the power of N is equals to phi of A whole to the power of N. So phi of A whole to the power of N is equals to phi of A to the power of N is equals to phi of E. What is the property 1? Phi of A is equals to E cap. So identity is mapping with identity only. So phi of A whole to the power of N is equals to E cap. This shows that order of phi of A is equals to small n by the definition of the order of an element. So modulus of phi of A is a divisor of small n. Nothing but modulus of phi of A divides modulus of A. Fourth one, ker pi is a, we have to show that ker pi is a subgroup of capital G. By the one-step subgroup test, what is the one-step subgroup test? A comma B belongs to A comma B belongs to capital H implies AB inverse belongs to capital H. Same as first, by the definition of the ker pi, A belongs to G, phi of A is equals to E cap. We know that ker pi is a subset or equals to capital G. From 1, what is the property 1? Identity is mapping with identity only. Phi of E is equals to E cap. So therefore, E belongs to ker pi. This shows that ker pi is a non-empty set. Next, we have to show that this is a subgroup of capital G. Here, ker pi is A belongs to G, phi of A is equals to E cap. Nothing but it contains all the elements which are mapping with identity. So let A comma B belongs to ker pi, phi of A is equals to E cap, phi of B is equals to E cap by the definition of the ker pi. Phi of A into B inverse. Phi is a homomorphism. So phi of A into phi of B inverse. Phi of A, phi of B inverse. By the property 2, from 2, second property, phi of B whole inverse. Phi of A is equals to E cap. Phi of B is equals to E cap whole inverse. E cap into E cap is equals to E cap. So the image of the AB inverse is equals to E cap. So therefore AB inverse belongs to ker pi because ker pi contains all the elements which are mapping with the identity. By the one step subgroup test, ker pi is a subgroup of capital G. Next one, what we have to show that homomorphic image. We have to show that homomorphic image is a subgroup of G cap. First, we have to write the definition homomorphic image. Phi of G is equals to B. B belongs to G cap. B is equals to phi of. It contains all the codomain elements, nothing but the range elements. From 1, phi of E is equals to E cap. So E cap belongs to phi of G. What is the phi of G? Phi of G is equals to B belongs to G cap. So E belongs to G, E cap belongs to G cap. So E belongs to phi of G. Phi of G is a non-empty set. So here also we have to using one step subgroup test. B1 comma B2 belongs to phi of G. It contains all the codomain elements, nothing but range elements. B1 is equals to phi of A1, B2 is equals to phi of A2, where A1 comma A2 belongs to G. Here also A belongs to G. B1 into B2 inverse, phi of A1 into phi of A2 whole inverse. Phi of A1 by the property 2, phi of A2 inverse. Since phi is a homomorphism, phi of A1 into A2 inverse. B1 into B2 inverse is equals to phi of A1 into A2 inverse. So nothing but B1 into B2 inverse also has an image. Also has a pre-image. B1 into B2 inverse belongs to phi of G. So B1 into B2 inverse phi of G. Therefore phi of G is a subgroup of G cap. It is another theorem. Let phi from G to G cap be a homomorphism, then ker pi is a normal subgroup of capital G. We know that what is the normal subgroup definition? XH, X inverse belongs to capital H. This is the definition of the normals. Capital H is any subgroup of capital G. And if XH, X inverse belongs to capital H, for all X belongs to capital G and small h belongs to capital H. So then, capital H is a normal subgroup of capital G. So, by the property 1, phi of E is equals to E cap. So, therefore, this shows that ker pi is a non-empty set. Ker pi contains all the elements which are matching with identity. A belongs to G, phi of E is equals to E cap. So, phi of E is equals to E cap, ker pi is a non-empty set. So, let X belongs to G, A belongs to ker pi. So, phi of X into A. XA, X inverse. By using the definition of the normal subgroup, phi of X into phi of A into phi of X inverse. Because since phi is a homomorphism, phi of X, phi of A is equals to E cap because A belongs to ker pi. Ker pi contains all the elements which are mapping with the identity by the definition of the ker pi. So phi of X whole inverse. This is the property from the second property. So, phi of x into any element multiplying with identity, we get same element. So, phi of x whole inverse by the property of second one. We know that these are the elements of the G cap. So, G cap is a group. By the inverse property, phi of x into phi of x inverse is equals to E cap. So, therefore, the image of the XA, X inverse is equals to E cap. So, XA, X inverse belongs to ker pi. For all X belongs to G and A belongs to ker pi. This shows that ker pi is a normal subgroup of capital G.